The Fed President Jerome Powell's testimony before US Congress went smoothly yesterday. Global investors were more than happy to hear that the Fed is still thinking of cutting its interest rates sometime this year, even if the US inflation doesn't hit that 2% mark. Now today, the European Central Bank will announce its own monetary policy verdict and is expected to revise its inflation target lower, while bets that the Bank of Japan will exit the negative rate policy finally, sooner rather than later, is giving a decent boost to the Japanese yen this morning. So welcome, this is Swissquote, daily market talk. So the Fed Chair Jerome Powell's testimony before the US Congress went, well, quite smoothly yesterday. Now, he didn't say anything big, mind you, but he said that the Federal Reserve will certainly cut the interest rates sometime this year. I think that all the market investors were aggressively pricing in already since the beginning of this year and the end of last year, but less and less enthusiastically since many economic data points from the US came to confirm that the US economy doesn't necessarily need a rate cut right away. So hearing that the Federal Reserve is still set to cut its interest rates was a relief for the overall market. Plus, Jerome Powell said that he's not necessarily looking for inflation to hit that 2% policy target to start cutting the interest rates. Making sure that inflation is on the right path would be enough, according to him. So, the US 2-year yield eased but remains above the levels that were in play before the Federal Reserve's December dot plot. Remember that dot plot that plotted the idea of a 75 base point cut plan this year? And the US 10-year yield fell below the 4.10% level. News that Steven Mnuchin, the former Treasury Secretary of Trump Times, remember, has led a $1 billion worth of cash injection into New York Community Bancorp also soothed investors' nerves at yesterday's trading session. Now, the bank rebounded more than 7.5%, and other banks in the US also learned from Jerome Powell's testimony yesterday that plans to ask banks to hold more capital was in for broad and material changes, and that a complete do-over was possible. So that's basically as good as it gets. And oh, the ADP print came in slightly lower than expected in February, and job openings fell in January, but they fell less than expected. But that's fine. The rest of the economic data and news were, well, rather supportive of an interest rate cut in the US sometime down the road. And the probability of a June rate cut from the Fed didn't change much after Jerome Powell's first day of testimony. Activity on Fed funds futures still gives around 70% chance for the first rate cut to happen in June in the US. Now, the US dollar index fell sharply below its 50-day moving average yesterday in the aftermath of a relatively dovish speech from the Fed President Jerome Powell. The dollar index tested a major Fibonacci support, which is the major 38.2% Fibonacci retracement level on the year-to-date rebound, which was happening, mind you, as investors were scaling back their Fed rate cut expectations, which were pointing at a 150 basis point cut at some time back in January. So below that Fibonacci level, which stands a touch above the 103 level, while the US dollar index will sink back into the medium-term bearish consolidation zone. Gold, on the other hand, rose yesterday to a fresh record and traded at $21.61 per ounce on the back of lower yields in the US. But again, if lower yields are why gold is up today, well, the upside potential should be limited by better appetite in other and for riskier assets that have juicier returns than the non-interest-bearing gold. But one thing is sure, the broadly softer US dollar will help other central bankers around the world to better cope with inflation at their regions and be able to cut their own interest rates on their turn. Now that we are talking about all of these other central banks, well, the Bank of Canada left its rate unchanged at 5% level as expected at yesterday's monetary policy meeting. And the European Central Bank will announce its latest monetary policy verdict today. Now, the European policymakers will leave rates unchanged, most likely today, but they will revise their economic projections. And that's exactly where investors will be hunting for precious information regarding when on earth the European Central Bank is planning to cut its interest rates this year, because there is a lot, but a lot of confusion and uncertainty regarding when these European friends could eventually start cutting their own interest rates this year, as many among them came to push back on expectations of a too early rate cut in Europe this year. And you know, they were right, really, given that the ECB does tend to get well ahead of themselves with the slightest smell of lower interest rates. So the European Central Bank is expected to revise its inflation forecast down today and hint that inflation in the euro area could reach the 2% target sooner than in their December projection. So if that's the case, if the European policymakers look confident enough that inflation is trending toward their 2% policy target, there will be nothing to prevent them from cutting the interest rates. The economic outlook in Europe is soft. Growth is clearly stagnating. And sufficiently soft inflation is pretty much the only missing thing to start cutting the rates. Now, on the euro front, the broad-based dollar depreciation yesterday sent the euro dollar above the 109 level at yesterday's trading session. A hint of a June rate cut from the ECB could quickly cast shadow on the euro bull's excitement to push this rally toward the 110 level. Because while both central banks, both the Fed and the ECB, are expected to start cutting their rates in June, the Federal Reserve is expected to cut by around 80 basis points this year, while the European Central Bank is seen cutting its own rates by 90 basis points. And the Fed's Neil Kashkari went a step further than that and said that the Fed could eventually cut rates two times only, or just one time this year, which would be nothing more than a 25 or a 50 basis point cut for the Federal Reserve. So that's fundamentally rational, given that the US economy performs well and it performs definitely better than the Eurozone economies, thanks to an ample fiscal support from the US government. But whatever is the reason, the European Central Bank could actually cut more if inflation is not a problem. So all this to say that the ECB decision today could reverse the euro appetite before the euro dollar makes a sustainable attempt above that 50% Fibonacci retracement on the year-to-date decline. Now, elsewhere, the UK's budget day went smoothly yesterday. The British voters were actually made happy with tax cuts from the government and other soothing news and giveaways on alcohol and fuel duty in the expense of some public spending and some public services. But hey, you know, you can't have it all. The 10-year gilt yield remained steady near 4% level, and cable could actually benefit from weaker US dollar across the board to drill above the top of its year-to-date negative trend. In Japan, the dollar-yen fell steeply below the 149 level as the Japanese wage growth accelerated at the fastest pace since June, and the latter fueled speculation that the Bank of Japan could hike its interest rates already at this month's monetary policy meeting. Now, knowing how cautious the BOJ is with its interest rate policy and inflation, I am not really sure that we will see a concrete action from the Bank of Japan at March 18-19 meeting, but maybe, but just maybe, the Bank of Japan will really exit the negative rate territory in the first half of this year. The thing is, you don't really take a big risk shorting the dollar-yen near the $150 psychological level, as the potential of a rise above this level is limited by direct intervention threat. So the only possible way is a downside. We just don't know when the real slide will begin. Maybe it's already begun. So this is all for today. I'm İpek Özkardeşkaya, and thank you for joining me, and thank you for all your beautiful and supportive comments. I hope This episode of Market Talk has been helpful and it has been insightful to you. So please do not hesitate to leave your comments, your reactions and your questions below as usual. Follow us on Instagram, on X and on LinkedIn for regular market updates. Subscribe to our YouTube channel for daily market comments and please do not forget to hit the like button on these videos to let us know that you enjoy them. So I will meet you again tomorrow. And until then, good day trading.